If you want to upgrade your old system with a blazing fast NVMe drive, you might need some kind of adapter to make that happen. NVMe SATA adapters exist, but these are limited to SATA bus speeds, which on my Fenvi M.2 machine means around 600 MB a second. Now, M.2 slots use 4 PCI Express lanes, which means you could basically just plug an M.2 NVMe drive into a PCI Express slot. You just need an adapter. Today, I will be testing 3 of the cheapest models I could find. Do they work at all? Will you get any decent speeds with them? Let's find out. To get some kind of baseline, I first ran a speed test on the SATA SSD already in this system, which is a cheap ADATA SU630 drive. In my very unscientific test, this one averaged around 560 MB a second read rate and 480 MB a second write rate. Not bad at all, given the maximum throughput of the SATA connection. Let's go on with the NVMe drive. I got this 500 GB Crucial NVMe drive, which according to the packaging should be able to reach a whopping 4700 MB a second read rate. If we can get anywhere close, I'd be very happy. The system I'm using only has PCIe 3.0 ports, so theoretically should be able to reach up to 1 GB a second using a PCIe X1 card and up to 4 GB a second on a PCIe X4 card. Let's see how close we get with each of the adapters I bought. The first card I'm testing is this GLOTRENDS PCIe X4 card I bought on Amazon for 8 euros. In the box, we find a piece of paper with some warnings we don't care about. A card with some information? That says there's an aluminium heatsink, but I guess they're referring to this low profile backplate. A small back with a grey and a black screw. A small screwdriver. And of course, the star of the show, the card itself. Let's put our NVMe drive on this card. Since this drive is shorter than the longest card it can take, we need to move the spare standoff to the 2280 position. This is a bit of an annoying task. You have to slide the standoff into the side of the NVMe, then hold it in place, while you screw it to the card on the backside. I put it into my machine's second PCIe X16 slot. Let's see what it does. It averages around 1.6 GB a second read rate and 1.2 GB write rate. Nowhere near the 4700 MB a second on the drive's package, but still a very nice upgrade from the 500-ish MB a second on the SATA SSD. Next, I'm trying this Fenvi, or Shenzhen Fenwi technology as the package states, X1 size card I bought on AliExpress for 2.5 euros. This one will be slower because it can only use one PCIe lane. But if it gets close to the 1 GB a second PCIe 3.0 speed, it might be okay for builds that don't have an X4 or bigger slot available. In the package, we just get the card, with a backplate and a few screws. Let's move my NVMe drive onto this one. Oh, oops! I should have screwed the backplate on before I added the drive. Right, all done. Let's see how well this one does. Well, this is a bit disappointing. It's way slower even than the cheap SATA SSD. It's about 1/4 of the previous card though, so I guess it makes sense. Not a great idea to get this one though. You're better off just hooking up a SATA drive. Last, but hopefully not least, we've got this Jeyi adapter I also bought on AliExpress for a whopping 5.5 euros. In the box we find the card, with a heatsink attached to it. A black backplate. Some Chinese, I'm too lazy to ask Google Translate what it says. Again a screwdriver. Some screws to mount the NVMe and the backplate. And a nice thumb screw to attach the card to your case. Underneath we find some thermal pads, which you would need to stick on your drive so it actually touches the heatsink. I'm not going to install the heatsink, because I don't think it will affect speed much. And if it does, I don't want it to provide an unfair advantage. This is again an X4 sized card. Let's see if it differs from the GLOTRENDS card I bought on Amazon. Pretty close! So both X4 cards perform about the same. The Amazon one just slightly faster. I tried just reading, by the way, to see if it would make any difference, but it didn't. I guess this is about as fast as it gets on PCIe 3.0. I do wonder what it will do in this very old Athlon 64 system. This machine has PCI Express 1.0 ports, so it should be limited to about 1 GB a second on 4 lanes. Could still be a nice upgrade though, since it's also limited to 150 MB a second on the SATA ports. A little over 3 times slower, that was to be expected. So how does this NVMe drive perform in an actual M.2 slot? For that, I'm opening up the mini PC from our living room, which we use for some light gaming. This machine has an Intel N100 APU, which means it's also limited to PCIe 3.0 speeds. By the way, if anyone knows how to get this mainboard out without breaking it, I'd love to learn from you, because I would very much like to change the noisy fan on this thing. As you can see here, the speeds are only a little bit higher than with the cheap X4 sized cards. So I guess we could agree that there's not a lot to gain in buying a more expensive card. There's one downside to using one of the cards I bought though. None of them come with a boot ROM, so you won't be able to boot from the NVMe drive unless your BIOS supports it, which it most probably won't if you don't already have an M.2 slot as well. This means you need a bootloader on another drive that can see the NVMe drive if you want to boot an OS from it. Would it be worth it? Well, as you have just observed, you get massively higher read and write speeds. So yeah, stuff should load quite a bit faster on an NVMe drive. The GLOTRENDS adapter is the only card I bought that accepts all sizes of NVMe drives. The other ones are limited to 2280 size, because of the placement of the M.2 slot. This still gives you plenty of choice for all adapters though, but it's something to consider. The heatsink provided with the even cheaper Jeyi adapter is a nice touch, but I don't think we would really need it with these kind of speeds. The only X1 sized card in this test would be a no-go. At least on PCIe 3.0 and lower, but I don't expect it to be a beast on PCIe 4.0 either. I do not own any machine with PCIe 4.0 ports or higher though, and if I did, there would be a good chance it would already be fitted with an M.2 slot as well. Tell me in the comments if you'd like an update as soon as I get my hands on a more modern board. This is all I have for you today though. There's a link to the NVMe drive and the cards in the description of this video, in case you want to check them out for yourself. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time!